the words of Duchess Josia, Duchess Kayla the Cheerful. I'm out of practice. And Duke Trumbrand the Wanderer, as they convene a court to conduct their final business from their time on the thrones of the North. With the leave of their majesties, Ritannicus and Isabel, they shall hold a regency court and conduct matters of importance. Herein opens their court.
Well, good morning. It is so fabulous to finally see everybody again. I feel like I've been asleep and I'm waking up like Dorothy's come to Oz and everything is again in color. Their majesties were kind enough to allow us to do a regency court to complete the business. We have been hanging on to all of this stuff in the safety of our home, dusting it, polishing it, up until this day. But if you think back, we did have a rain, and there were a lot of people whose help was invaluable to getting through that rain. Harold, would you be so kind as to recognize them for us?
Led by the formidable head of our entourage, Mistress Christiana McNamara, and encouraged by the dread Duchess Josia Valente, the following good gentles did serve the crown as entourage, and we would commend them. If you are present today, please stand as your name is recognized. Duke Roach of Ealdormere, Nyagina Kristina Vyacheslavovna, Countess Arlet of the Rozaki, Lady Isa Shambojuro, Countess and favorite daughter Lita, Lord Tristan Galbraith, Lady Sachin Bayan, Countess Hrokin, Viscountess Judith of Kirkland, Lady Margaret DeMay, Aramir the Archer, Mistress Catriona, Master Percival de la Roque, the Honorable Lord Daniel of Whitby, Arengar Svensson, Mistress Rosalind, Mistress Lucia Denzinus, Lady Dinwin, Katrina Preben's daughter, the Honorable Lady Brennett, Baroness Sabina of Aberdeen, Lady Dorothea of Holm, Blake, Baroness Augusta Wayfarer, Baroness Skaya Ingen-Cheneg, Lady Aileen, April, Baroness Pesha, Baroness Kirstkin Jan's doctor, Lord Henricus Vroom von Harlem, Naima, Lord Cormac Wolfson, Lady Mial, and Nyawood.
So all of these people helped us through our reign. We see a lot of people here who've done a reign before. You know how important these people are. And we just want to say thank you. And if we can ever return the favor, we're there for you.
For these, the first service of these fine gentles, wassail!
Now, there were also some of you who worked especially hard in the entourage department. And we would like you to come up personally and just kind of spread yourselves out so that you're nice and spread out, so that we can thank you personally. Would you call them forth, please?
Their graces invite forth Baron Sven Ragnaldson, the Honorable Lord Gajan Suren, the Honorable Lady Laura Batista, the Honorable Lord Cesare de Silvazzi, and Lord Eustace.
Thank you so much. You guys, thank you. You really helped us out so much. You were there like constantly behind us and looking up the gap.
So the four of these gentles, as well as Baron Sven, have kind of been the at any time, anywhere, anything people. And we just like to especially recognize them for their selflessness and their assistance. Thank you very much.
For the works of these good gentles,
wassail!
Now, all of these people whose names were called and whom you saw called up had to be organized. And that organization was due to Mistress Christiana, who could not be here today. However, we very much appreciate her her help, so we will be giving her an award of the Queen's and King's favor.
Shall I read the words?
Yes, please. If you would read the words.
The words of Queen Kaylah and King Trumbrand. Both the king, queen and king do award our royal favors to Mistress Christiana McNamara for serving as head of Entourage in yet another reign. We are well pleased that Entourage was always well organized, and we were always very well attended. For each event of our reign, enthusiastic volunteers were drafted by our stalwart and unflappable head of Entourage. Christiana welcomed newcomers. She corralled them into service, and likewise conscript into service stalwart older members of our great society. We thank Mistress Christiana for her strength and support through the reign. We commend and remain in awe of Christiana's legendary ability to induce and persuade the good people of Ealdormere to sign up for a 4-hour shift in attendance of the crown. And she makes it sound like fun. Witness our words and seal this day. For Mistress Christiana!
So I know it's been some time, so I had to leave myself a note. I use these wonderful little marvelous sticky things. And I'm looking at this note, and oh yes, I remember. Baron Brand, would you be so kind as to call up Justinian? I have a note for him.
Why, of course! Their graces demand the immediate presence of Justinian Claris to receive his note.
You realize you're making an old man move.
Their graces patiently await your presence.
Well, that's a good thing.
I vaguely remember you guys.
I know you. Justinian, I have here a note.
That would be all the singing we get today.
You were kind enough to sing us into crown tournament, and then you sang us into every court. And we are so very impressed with the fact that you were able to give your time and your voice again, to a reign, that we feel that such diligence certainly deserves a note. Would you go ahead and read that scroll, please?
The Pensic fields are empty now. So is the merchant row. The lines of tents folded away. Campfires no longer glow. The coopers have all gone to bed. The beer has ceased to foam. What spell could put this land to rights? A man to sing them home. The cannon sleeps upon the hill. No deeds the courts proclaim. The runestone's shadow, cold and still, the black flies hunt in vain. Bruise marks and bridges, shieldmen's treasures, buried beneath the loam, await new valor, clamor for a bard to sing king's home. No more the scarlet banner flies, no burnt boat burns on the lake, no war points, vigils, handfasts, hugs, the heart is like to break. Call back our wandering souls and fortunes. Far afield they roam. Debatable or not, our lands, Justinian, sing us home. For his service as royal bard, for all the reigns of Trumbrand and Kaylah and Trumbrand, and as bard of Ealdormere for many terms, and in celebration of his bravery and recall under pressure, all done with whimsy, we are pleased to make unto Justinian Claris an augmentation of arms. To wit, a musical note, which he may display upon his arms.
Justinian, thank you so much. You may keep your note.
That's my second one. Okay. Yeah, I got one from Doug.
One more augmented with a note. Thank you very much.
For Baron Justinian!
What's hail!
I believe that we had another person who helped much with our reign. Would you be so kind as to invite Gerard into court, please?
Their graces, invite before them Baron Gerard Carpentarius.
And games and toys.
Tedious.
There we go. We have a little comb puppet, and it has a little coronet just like yours, and it has a scroll attached
Somebody's
to the comb.
Somebody's been mischievously busy. Thank
Can
you.
Can we read that scroll, please?
Absolutely. Kaylah, Queen by right of arms, and Trumbrand, King of Grace and Patience. To our royal toy maker, Baron Gerard Carpentarius, in token of joy and merriment rendered unto the kingdom of Ealdormere, gift unto him an augmentation of arms in a form that pleases him, such as in the form of a wee little puppet toy. To be registered and displayed as a token of our esteem, done on this day of the acknowledgement of the coronation of our heirs.
Thank you. We understand that you're retiring from the toy business. But you know what? So long as you have toys, you will always be young. We gift you your baldric in perfect.
So if I take it off officially, I need to put it on to just Gerard.
Put it back on as just Gerard.
That would be wonderful.
And thank you,
thank
so,
you so
much.
Appreciate it.
Thank
oh
you.
My gosh, that's crazy. I love it. Thank you very much.
For Baron Gerard!
What's hail?
Now where we have to dismiss the wonderful people who guarded us. Would you please call up our champions?
Their graces, call forth those who served as their champions. Mistress Kirstigan Jansdoctor, Sir Richard Larmer, and Viscountess Elizabeth Mortimer.
Oh, thank you.
You lost the cameraman.
He did.
Well, the cameraman had to have work. There's no rest. There is no rhyme. As you have helped me through this reign as my champion, I would gift you with your own lady rat.
Yay!
So that you too may find solace in stroking the rat's fur and occasionally pulling the tail.
Just in the privacy of the
But it helps in the end.
I love you so much.
Truly epic courts, holding the sword proudly, and the courts just kept going, and Richard kept holding it.
I'm from Rising Waters, I'm used to long courts.
Yes.
Well trained.
And we know that you have been slightly augmented with your animal self, and we took the liberty of contacting the World Wildlife Federation, and we have adopted for you an adoption certificate in your name for the closest animal we could find. A bison!
Oh my god, I love it.
That's wonderful. Thank you.
So this is for you with the heart of a bison.
And Sir Elizabeth was my champion. She couldn't be here today, so we actually met with her last weekend, and we had adopted a red wolf.
Graces call forth the dread but unfailingly helpful Duchess Josiah Valente.
On this earth.
Both the Queen and King, do award our royal favors to Duchess Josiah for stalwart stewardship of our royal adventures by serving as our royal chamberlain for a record-breaking 4 times. Never before has a chamberlain volunteered to manage the royalty so many times and still yet retain the hair on her head. Each and every reign, we were tended, cared for, herded, planned for, and on special occasions, Josiah even pretended to listen to us. Pillow day did not come, nor were we pelted with vegetable produce. We thank the dread Duchess Josiah for being so very helpful through all 4 reigns, for serving the crown with a reasonable facsimile of a smile, even under the most dire of circumstances, for true grace under pressure. We are blessed to have Josiah's helpful service and grateful for, at the end of it all, we are still friends.
I know.
That we said it in court and everything.
Thank you very much, Kayla.
Love you,
Trumbrand.
I love you,
Kayla.
For Duchess Josiah.
Well, well,
and throughout our reign, I've noticed that we also received some help from somebody else.
Yeah.
That guy.
Seems to go together, kinda.
Kinda matches. Brad, would you come up here, please, for a moment?
Their graces call me.
So you have actually been very helpful.
Awesome.
Is Dietrich around?
There
he is. Dietrich, would you mind giving voice to how we feel about Brand's health? And it will be good.
And remember, this is a family show.
Oh, so no hand gestures, then.
Lord.
Both Duchess Kayla and Duke Trumbrand do give our thanks to Master Brand Thorwaldsen for his helpful work as the voice of the crown, both aloud in court and in the writing of scroll wordings. No matter the level of the award or the shenanigans that occur in court, Brand somehow knows just what turn of phrase will be appropriate, historical, whimsical, humorous, serious, applicable, legitimate, and acceptable to the crown. We are grateful for his help in all manner of verbal quandaries and for the volume with which he can convey the crown's wishes. We thank Master Brand for his very helpful service, and we are grateful that at the end of it all, we still have our hearing. This proclamation, styled in the fashion of our ancestors, Duke Siegfried and Countess Ragni, is not an award and carries no precedence.
So we made you a little thing. And let's see, this one says, oh wait, this one says helpful Josiah.
Their Majesty, or their graces, call forth helpful Josiah.
It's not a competition either.
It's a competition.
And just in case there's any doubt, it is indeed a competition.
And we can put it on our walls. You are officially helpful. There is your helpful scrolls, signed, sealed, and framed.
Oh, gracious. Mm-hmm. Chainsaw?
Uplifting?
Absolutely. That's awesome. Thank you so much. This is beautiful.
For the services of helpful Brand and the even more helpful Josiah.
What's up? Yeah.
All right, get back to work. All right.
That about does it. I believe we have finished.
Would you like me to close your court?
One quick thing. Thank you, Ealdormere, for your patience. We know it's been a long time, and the deeds that we were recognizing here are in the far distant past that some of our brains can barely remember, but we at least tried to get through it. Thank you for your patience.
There being no further outstanding business from the reign of Kayla and Trumbrand, and all rightful things have been done and said, herein closes this Regency Court. For Kayla and Trumbrand!
What? Yeah!